Hi, I'm Charu, and I am here for faculty interior designing. And so I'll tell you something about myself, starting from the family, I think. So basically, I put up in Pithampura in North Delhi, and I have two siblings, and my father has a business of jewelry, and we are a nuclear family. And then proceeding with my studies, I have completed my schooling from Sachdeva Public School, which is again in Pithampura only. And then proceeding towards my graduation, I have done two graduations. One is BCom, and another one is BSc in Interior Designing, which is from Amity University. The first one that I did, BCom, that was from Delhi University, which was from Open, like a distance learning thing. Because I didn't want to leave my background, which is commerce. I've done my 11th and 12th in commerce background. So I didn't want to leave that background as well. But I didn't want to do something which was, really thoda sa different from my commerce background. So I had inclined towards interior designing. In my resume, it's not mentioned, but I have done a diploma course from JD as well. In the first year, I had to leave is because. Can I speak over?
Yeah.
So basically, I had to leave is because of the fact. After 8 months, I had got more inclined towards interior design. So 1 year wasn't actually. I thought that it's not sufficient for me to proceed in this profession. So I thought of doing something which was really detailed. So I went for interior designing, which was 3 years program from Amity University. In my third year, I thought after the second year internship and everything had happened, I was lucky to get an internship at a very nice firm, which was VMA Associates. And therein I got to learn a lot. And then after proceeding with 6 months internship, I started doing work over there and as a interim job source. So I did work over there as well for 6 months period, and then after that I completed my third year. So with the third year I was working as well as a freelancer and at that job as well. After completing my graduation, I had joined to one of the firms, which is Creation Design. So that's basically in Noida only. And I did work over there for a really long period of time. And I did work on residential projects, commercial projects, and learned a lot over there as well. Since it was my first year after the graduation had finished, I was really learning a lot. Then in the second phase, after taking a pause and learning, grasping a lot of things, I had joined to Sparrow Interactive, which is a 3D company. So therein I was a project manager, interior designer. It was a very different job. For a really long time I had a thing for project managers is because of the fact that they manage a lot of things at the same point of time. So you do a lot of managing at the same point of time for the whole project. So basically what my thing was in that, my role in that company was, I was in interior designing and I had to do the designing into the walkthrough. So whatever builders have the budget, like your 40 lakh budget, and then you have to design as per that. So a quotation was given to us, a list of material was given to us, and we had to design according to that. That got executed on site and everything. That's completely their choice. So then again I proceeded. I took a 5 month break, which is mentioned in my resume as well. Is because of the fact that I wanted to learn a lot in interior designing, in the matter of fact that my reading little books, getting my theories cleared and everything, that happened. And at the same point of time, I am not someone who's into sitting at home and passing the time and everything. I will be completely honest, I am doing freelancing a lot. So at that point of time as well, I did a lot of freelancing. I got opportunities of doing freelancing at that point of time as well. So I did that. After that, I had joined Academy of Applied Arts, which is in which has both of the campuses in North Delhi as well, and in South Campus as well. So there I got a opportunity to impart my knowledge to a lot of students. And I was teaching interior designing as well. I was teaching visual merchandising as well at that point of time. And they had another program which was LRD, which was luxury residential design. So basically in that, three programs very different from my forte. I did not learn anything about visual merchandising, but when it came to my coach, then I had to learn a lot, read a lot about that. So I did learn a lot of retail designing as well. LRD was another course which was luxury residential design, which was completely different from what we had learned in interior design, which was going upscale basically, of how, of in terms of materials, in terms of a lot of things, designing and how you choose the color schemes and everything. So that was that. This was about my resume. Now again, I am working at Grow Ever Infracorp, which is a construction company who basically deals in all the government projects. They have nothing which is private. We have nothing which is which we do on a private sector. We only deal with central and state government projects, which is probably working with CPWD, Government of Haryana, and this and that. Alright, so I'll start with the presentation. So whenever we talk about interior designing, one of the factors that come into our minds is interior styling. So interior styling is one of the major factors which I think is very, very important for every student to learn what is modern, what is contemporary, what is Victorian. Is because of the fact whenever we go, I think we need to converse with our client and understand what sort of thinking do they have, what sort of understanding do they have for the project, what all do they want in their house. So interior designing, interior styling and interior designing are correlated. So the first thing that we start with, three things. First is only consultancy, another thing is turnkey, and the third thing is visual merchandising. So three things that you merge up and become impart a thing which is interior design. So in design consultancy, you only probably just design. So it basically deals with providing the drawings to the client, understanding only, not, it does not include the execution at all. It only imparts interior, only the designing basically. In that you provide AutoCAD drawings and probably understand what sort of thing do you, does the client want, what sort of designing does the client want. Second thing is getting into turnkey projects. So basically turnkey means something which is everything into that, you're the whole and soul of the project. So you do everything in that project. Starting from the execution, concept planning, concept designing, getting the drawings done, working drawings, getting the furniture designed and everything. So the third thing which comes up is visual merchandising, wherein you do only and only making the whole and soul look of the house look visual, like it looks good. So the three things are there in interior designing, which you can do separately as well and merge up them and do the complete project as well. So the first thing comes up, modern style. What happens in modern style? What is modern basically?
Are you talking here about consultancy?
No, I'm talking about interior styling. So the three things that you include in any of interior designing is consultancy, second is turnkey, third is only visual merchandising. So three of any one of three you can choose for any of the project.
No, but where is interior styling then in those three levels?
Only consultancy.
Oh.
Consultancy. So modern style, so the first thing that comes up in modern style is basically something which is clean line, something which goes, something which is a little dark, but at the same point of time it is a little subtle as well. So not a lot of accessories are used in that, not a lot of colors are used in that. Colors which are used in any of interior in modern is only neutrals. So you basically deal with browns, shades and tints of browns, shades and grey, white, black. That is how you go in modern. It's very clean line. No other geometrical shapes are used, only corners are used. If any geometrical shapes are used, they are balanced with colors at the same point of time. Modern style is ideal for apartments, small places, as it maximizes the space and creates the impression that a room is larger than it equally is actually is. Minimal textures, bold geometrical forms, neutral colors accented with a single bold color along with polished finishes and asymmetrical balance are key identifying features of modern style interiors. So basically, now a lot of confusion happens between modern style and contemporary style as well. So modern style has a lot of ample daylighting. Use of lot of windows are done in modern style. Wooden flooring is preferred when you do a modern styling thing. Cove lightings, a lot of wood is used in modern styling. So wooden walls ho gaya, wall cladding ho gaya, paneling ho gaya, these things are used. As you can see, wooden walls, glass dressing, tables, glass wardrobe, carpet flooring, moonlighting. So I think a lot of colors makes any of the use of a lot of colors, I think destroys the basic look of any of the interior. So I think modern styling includes a lot of subtleness and a lot of grace to everything. Then comes minimalistic interior designing. Now this style basically has a lot of implication whenever you design any of a small place and you want that space to look a lot bigger, then you probably should go for minimalistic design, is because of the fact the first thing that is the rule of minimalistic design is that you should always understand what is the need of that area. So anything which has no use in that area, which will be like an artifact thing only for that area, you should never use that for minimalistic design, is because of the fact anything. Now if we see this picture, what do you need basically in a bedroom? Like side table, a bed. I think what, since it's such a luxurious sort of a room, the wardrobe will be on the probably left hand side or on a different room, like a walk-in wardrobe sorts. And the only artifact or probably the only showpiece that is kept in the room is just a flower pot, which adds a lot of visual impact of the picture or in the designing. And you just have side tables and a bed. That's it. No artifact, nothing is used, not even the paintings. Now the wall is basically, if you see, if I would have just done a simple lighting, not have used the spotlights, I would have probably used a painting on it. But I don't need a painting on the wall, is because of the fact the spotlights are making a lot of impact on the wall itself. So I don't need a painting for that. I don't need any artifact on any of the walls. Now when we proceed, minimalistic design. Now when you see in both of the pictures, monochromatic color scheme is used, minimal use of furniture, wooden flooring, and encouraging open spaces. Minimalistic design always encourages open spaces. When you see something which is like really open and no other furniture, it's not cluttered, it's very decluttered, it's very open, it's very airy, that is what you have in minimalistic design.
So both these are minimalistic.
Now proceeding towards next styling is contemporary interior designing. Contemporary style interior design. Now what happens in this? Contemporary for me means something which is trendy, something which goes in trend, something which is nowadays going on. So that becomes contemporary. Be it any color in the interior designing, be it any furniture piece in interior designing, be it any material which is used nowadays. So anything which is in now in the fashion, in the trend, becomes contemporary. Contemporary interior designing are comfortable and welcome without being cluttered. Dark is a style that is equally appropriate for offices, stores, blocks, or and homes. A contemporary style can home can be quiet and comfortable retreat. Now, one of the key features in contemporary is it depends. It can be merged around with the need of the client. Is because there is no constraint in this that you have to do this or you have to do that. You can use a lot of colors in that, but I think for me, adding color. Adding two or three more colors in any of the house makes the house lose its charm. So I think use of colors should be minimalistic, and using colors with neutrals should be encouraged. So you can use a gray, a white, and a orange, which is used over here, or a black and white and orange. And something of a lighter shade or tint can go on the wall. So something like that could be done. Adding colors with the neutrals adds, I think, more charm to the house. Now, line can be used through the use of vibrant color, block, high ceiling, square furniture, linear wooden floors, floor mats, bare windows, geometric shapes in wall art sculptures. Each piece stands out as individual and unique. So a lot of artifacts can be used in that, a lot of carpets, rugs. You can match up along with the color of the sofa or cloth of the sofa, or you can use a lot of colors, prints in the cushions. So that's about contemporary interior style. Now again, the another example in contemporary style is this, when we've used again not a lot of colors, gray flooring, white walls, white furniture. But only one color is added into that, which is a mustard yellow. So that adds up a lot of appeal to the styling. In fact, the lighting or the paint, wallpaper on the wall, which is used over here, has gone on the yellow side. And it's not a warm white color, it's a yellow color. Now, one of the styles which have been used a lot and which has, I think, been used wrongly in our houses is classic interior styling. So classic means something which has carving, but at the same point of time it has to look really royal. Is because of the fact whenever we think of something classic, I think it does not come into our mind that something which is gaudy, something which is, you know, very shiny, nothing like that. So basically a very soft, muted colors are used, pastel shades are encouraged in classic interior styling. A lot of carving is done, use of glasses are a lot of in trend. So basically in this thing, ornate furniture in classic interior designing, one chooses to accent with whites. Choose off-white if you want to stay in keeping with a more authentic classic color palette. Choose bright white if you want a slightly more contemporary feel instead. Usually the color palette is commonly inspired by nature. A variety of yellows, blues, greens, browns, as well as softer muted hues like terracottas, grey and pink are commonly used. So anything that you want to ask from this?
I will ask.
So use of a lot of floral is done in classic. Floral prints ho gaye aapke. You can use a lot of wallpapers on the wall. Use of gold finishes, classic chandeliers are used in classic style interior. Then comes Victorian. Now one of the I think a merger of classic and Victorian can be done in the houses. Victorian style is often described as opulent and luxurious. Victorian style is near opposite to minimalism. It is based on excessive amount of ornate and flamboyant decorations, accessories, and the more you have display, the more you display it, the better it is. So a lot of artifacts are used, a lot of chandeliers, a lot of colors are used. Dark color scheme is encouraged in Victorian designing. The excessive decorative furniture on it are contrasted by plain floors and wall surfaces. Deep hues are used, pastel, neutral colors contrast the rich textures, again the bright side of the upholstery and wall coverings. Now whenever we think of Victorian style, some of the example is this. So now a lot of motif is used on the wall. It's a very dark color, but at the same point of time it has been contrasted with a furniture piece which is white in color, and a very plain flooring is used with only one piece of art is used. Glass tables, bright shades of furniture, carved mirror frames are used a lot in Victorian style.
Okay, Shalu, first I want to understand from you what is the difference between style and look.
Style and look. So styling is basically whenever you merge up a lot of things, you gather a lot of things, you take little bit of everything and you make a visual appearance of that thing. So that is what we call a look. Look and feel of the house is very nice, but the process of completing that look and feel is what we call style.
So what's the difference? So you're saying look is a wider term and style is a part of it.
Styling, look is the outcome of styling.
Look is the outcome of styling. And can't we divide the whole styling thing into three segments like classic, casuals and contemporary?
We can. But,
I mean, because when you talk about Victoria and you talk about classic, you are giving the reference of British time period. So Victorian was also one time period during the Britishers.
Exactly.
So I mean, how does
like
it matter why we are segmenting it?
I that's a list of interior styling. You can segment different.
See, these are maybe the theories given by somebody in the interior. So can't we as teachers should be changing and making it more appropriate, which is acceptable? I mean, when you say modern and when you say contemporary, modern for me, as per my understanding, is anything that is latest. I mean, latest technology, censored buttons, censored light and all that is modern, because that is happening. That is the need of today's generation. But when you talk about contemporary, if you talk about me, I'm old school person, but who wants to live in the modern scenario. So I would try and merge up the old and the new and make it into something which is contemporary acceptable. So I mean, why can't we segment it, and why we have to, as interior person or as interior teacher, have to follow the rules and theories that have been set? Why can't we segment it further and make it more organized?
We can, but this was just a list of interior styles that I had. We can, actually it should be segmented according to what sort of time period that they had.
Yes.
That at what point of time, for 10 years, what sort of styling was done in the houses, another century, what was styling was done in the houses, what came. So that is what you call, that is what you have after, this is what you teach in the third year, I think, or the second year, wherein you learnt a lot about the history of the interior designing, when you understand Renaissance, Baroque and everything, you've learnt everything and then you go along with that.
And when it comes to style and look, what my understanding is, style is something very individual and look is something that you want to achieve too. What you rightly said, it's an output. So supposedly if I want to give a Victorian look, but I would style my house as per my own individuality, not as per somebody's. So style is very individual and it is not a part of look. Like if whatever you're wearing, if you ask me to wear it, I might be wearing the same clothes, but to carry that would be my style. So that is very individual, whereas the look would be, our look would be the same. That is what is the class. Okay, what would be the exercise that you would give after doing this? Supposedly you have taken this as a subject in the class, what would be the exercise that you would give or an activity that you would give?
Since I said that this is taught after after good theory classes of history of architecture or interior design for that matter, so I think at that point of time I would suggest them whatever project that they have done of residential or probably of the same genre, I would tell them to design it in whatever style that they want and present a model, present something which is which probably you do to a client. So that is what you that is what you have thought about that project, and that this is what you're going to do in future with all the materials, with all of the mood boards and everything.
So you want to give them a design project.
Yeah.
And why do you want to come into education? You have taught one in one of the colleges, but now why do you want to bounce back? Do you enjoy that period of interacting?
I did enjoy a lot at that point of time is because of the fact you you get to first of all learn a lot at that point of time, and you get to impart your knowledge at that point of time. Both of that happens, and for students you try and learn more. So I want to try and I want that thing that I should be able to learn so much that I can impart a lot of knowledge to those students.
Okay, and you have studied it interior also, and you have taught. Do you find any gap that you want to blend when you were a student and now you are a teacher? So being a faculty and being a student, was there a gap that you felt that should have been taught to you to be a better executor when you were doing projects for different companies and all that?
What happened was when I was learning, the first thing that I really felt after going, after passing out from my college was a lack of practicality was there.
Okay.
So in that first year is obviously a design thing and you getting to know about interior design and you're not really into that. So after the first year, I would actually take my students to a lot of site, get them practical knowledge as much as possible, is because of the fact whatever is in theory, you can actually rata maar ke sab likh ke aa sakte ho, aap sab pad sakte ho. But whenever you go outside, the world is not that soft to you. So a lot of practicality that it needs to be faced outside. Nobody really hears your tantrums. Nobody really cares if you're awake or awake at night or not. You're supposed to get your work done. So in that phase, I'll try and teach the students that you have to pull your socks up no matter what happens, and you have to perform no matter what.
So you felt that when you were a student, you were not giving enough and more exposure. You would have yes.
I would have. There was lack of market service which was there. I made sure that in the academy that I take to them a lot of exhibitions. I go to the market, get myself.
And this exhibition and this market survey, how often does this from the second year? The students are in the third semester.
Mm-hmm.
A semester is for 6 months.
Mm-hmm.
So how many times would you take that group of students to an outdoor activity?
In one and a half month is because of the fact I think students should really get to grasp that thing into the designing. So I think a 1 month time with frequent exercises and frequent projects should make them able to get into their minds ki this is what we had learnt into the market and this is what we had created. This is what we had seen in the exhibitions, and this is what we can do in our projects as well. So I think 1.5 months would be enough for them.
So about thrice or four times during that 6 months of time?
4 or 5 times according to what sort of events which are happening in Delhi. A lot of exhibitions, a lot of small exhibitions about kitchens, about modular furniture, about fire safety, HVACs, a lot of these happens. So I'll take them home. That's not a...
And I want to ask you, would you like to join us as a part-timer or a full-timer? We work 6 days a week from 9:30 to 5:30.
Mm-hmm.
That is our schedule.
Mm-hmm.
So that is how our working scenario is.
I wouldn't mind full-time.
And when can you join?
After 20 days.
So I take it as 1 month notice. And what is the subjects that you would want to take? The list of subjects you have already mentioned. If you can just give me a little list of it. Your code.
I can take furniture designing. I can take
just a second. Yeah.
Furniture designing, design principles. Another gap that I found was a lack of presentation was there. So I would really want my students to be able to speak what they are thinking. So that's really important, is because whenever you go to a client or whenever you go to a company, you don't actually, you can't speak what you're thinking. So I would actually work upon that as well. A lot of presentations,
skills.
Presentation skills.
Okay, Charu, here I want to ask you, what do you think in presentation skills that you would be teaching? If suppose I have to ask you to teach my students,
mm-hmm.
where would you start and what is the output of it? I mean, how would you, if I supposedly I'm your student, how would you want me to start with in terms of presentation skills?
The first thing that I would want you to understand that for any of the project is very necessary to understand the core of that. What do you want to design? And you need to learn about that thing correctly.
And so this is which semester you're talking about?
I think we should start about in the third semester itself, is because first is like theory, they're getting their hands onto the paper and then drafting and everything. So I think second year would be completely fine for them to start for the presentation skills. So now the concept planning comes, you should be able to understand what are you thinking. The next thing is that you should be able to put down probably on a piece of paper in the form of a list or a paragraph or anything. And you should be able to, not necessarily that you present it in 10 slides, present it in bits and pieces. Present what you have in your mind in terms of probably the styling, probably what do you want to do in terms of furniture. So there are basic things.
So this is what you're talking in terms of the subject and the content
in generalism.
And in communication.
In communication as well.
What else? I mean, if you have to make me fine tune, where would you start from?
I would probably tell the person to, if not speak, write.
That is again communication. Okay, what I am looking is, if suppose you are my student, I would start with the grooming.
Mm-hmm.
How to stand, body language, what you to
okay,
speak.
Okay, that terms you are saying. Okay,
yes.
Okay. Like from a scratch.
Yes,
okay.
You have
so
to start with the from
the
a scratch, which is,
okay, so body.
See, if you, uh-huh. if you might have noticed the generation that we are into, maybe you are in between me and the present generation,
mm-hmm.
you are that generation. So, they come to college in slippers. So you have to start from there that you cannot wear this, you cannot wear that, you cannot wear this. You can.
Exactly.
You have to tell
you
them.
Have to, I have to. So basically, so now I understood your point.
Yeah.
Now in the first place, you have to start. First impression is the last impression. So when you see something, when you look at something, you should feel nice about that thing. So I think the first thing is the dressing, is because of the fact. आप कभी भी किसी से मिलने जाते हो यू नीड टू लुक लॉट सीरियस अबाउट दैट थिंग और यू नीड टू लुक लाइक एन इंटीरियर डिजाइनर फॉर दैट मैटर सो फर्स्ट थिंग इज ड्रेस कोड द सेकेंड थिंग दैट आई वुड वर्क अपॉन इज हाउ यू स्टार्ट अ कॉन्वर्सेशन हाउ यू ग्रीट अ पर्सन वॉट शुड यू से वॉट शुड यू नॉट से एट दैट पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम थर्ड इज जेस्चर्स how you brief the senior
okay,
people.
So after you briefing, supposedly you give them a list of 10 things that you should do this, not this. How would you bring that into a practice of every person's, I mean, there are 20 students in your class.
Mm-hmm.
So how would you start telling them that you cannot, pinpoint
but
me and telling me, you cannot wear this, you have to come next day. So next day I would not come to your class.
Mm-hmm.
So how would you make it interesting that gradually in the process of you teaching presentation skills,
mm-hmm.
they upgrade themselves in terms of gestures, body language, clothing, neatness, hygiene, language, communication, everything. How would you make it interesting? How, what would be the activities that you can think of?
I think personally that that depends upon what sort of person that I'm teaching to as well.
There are 20 kids.
How do you grasp as well the thing? But I think I will not be able to explain this thing to you at this point of time, but I think I have this thing that I convince a lot of people for these things, like presentation skills or dressing up nicely or to make an impression for the other person. And if someone has, I have learned this thing, if someone takes up your advice, you should always appreciate the student problem.
So you're saying maybe through motivation and appreciation,
yeah,
you would...
Like a nice gesture, nice smile, you're looking nice, so you took up my advice. I think that encourages the student a lot.
Okay. Alright, can we talk about your remuneration also, please?
I'm taking that 145,000 in hand. And whatever suits you.
So, I also want to mention here that the industry and academics, there's a gap in terms of monetary.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not saying that we don't pay well,
mm-hmm,
but normally we do not pay as good as the industry does,
mm-hmm,
because it is, in industry, it is the circulation of money that happens every day.
Mm-hmm.
But yes, we pay handsome salaries.
Mm-hmm.
So I would quote as 45 for present, and then we can talk about it. Yeah?
45?
Yeah. What is in hand? I mean, you have to pay your taxes.
45, I get in hand after the TDS and everything is cut. After that, I get 45.
Okay, so we'll talk about it.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you, Charu.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.